Hello everyone, it's Claire and we are going to speak again about TikTok. So here you see the filter that you have on TikTok. So it's something that is used a lot and it does influence the trends and you should use it in advertising. I have some examples just below and we are going to speak about other applications that are using it. So here you see, for instance, Uni, that is a utility app. They directly use filter that you have. If you can have a filter with your game, it's even better. And if you can make it a trend, it's even better. So here you see, like, those filters, they are in the application. People, they use it when they publish their story. So this is important to acknowledge. Then you have, for instance, this ringtone application. They are using this Harry Potter wallpaper when you see it, and it's not for nothing. It's because Harry Potter is currently a trend, so they are using this reference, and they also have in the TikTok application, as you saw on my first thing, they do have a filter with Harry Potter, so it's used a lot by the community. Then you have I'm going to go back on the gaming companies, but please take example as well outside of gaming. Gaming is not super mature right now on TikTok, so I feel like each vertical will get good insight to do creative. So if you take War Alliance by Good Game Studio, what I like is the 3D character. It looks more like a real person, which is really important. And you see all the key elements with the stars, for instance, that appear after the 3 seconds. So really interesting one. Then you have Mirage, Perfect Skyline by EU. They are advertising massively. It's a shame that it's always in horizontal because they are really interesting things. Here you see a real end with some magic power in it. And this is really interesting. And this could be a TikTok trend, you know, like to have this kind of effect that the community could use. So I feel like this is the kind of content that is working pretty well on TikTok. Then you have Empire for Kingdom by Good Game. So they are doing a lot of really good ads lately on the platform. Here you see basically a person that get a strong eye contact with you and explain you how it's working. So it's really nice and it really looks like an organic content. Then you have Rise of Kingdom. So they are doing a lot of ads on TikTok and they have a lot of different narratives. It's too bad that they are doing it in square because it's really great stories. Here you have a guy that at the beginning doesn't have enough in-game currency basically to get what he wants. Then he gets richer and he gets what he wants, and then he explains why. Which is really, really nice. Then you have I think what is really good as well is that usually they use a lot of numbers when they show basically what is working or not. If you go back on Strike of Nation by Babil Games, you see as well this trend of using flags to win a territory that is used a lot. And also this text that is looking really native, like if someone made a TikTok and just added some text. This ad, I feel, is really, really strong and kind of look organic. So I think it's really the best. Then you have Baseball Clash by Miniclip. It's a really high quality concept that is, in my sense, really strong. A lot is happening. You see the home run is highlighted with the character that get an eye contact with you. It's 3D, so it looks almost like a real person. And you have all the sparky elements with the confetti and also the scoring. We see a lot of numbers on TikTok, so it's good always to showcase some. Then you have Strike of Nation by Babil Games. So they are using as well both flag things. Here you can see US, you can see a lot of different nations, and basically they use it in their advertising. So here you have a really nice ad that I think can be taken as an example. The VS thing is something that is used a lot as well in TikTok, so really nice use of it. Zero Nation, Zero City by Mycom. So this one is really interesting because it's a lot of interesting colors I see, and a lot is going on. So it's fairly a lot gameplay oriented, but I feel like it fits at least to the format with the vertical shot. So it's really nice made. Then if we take Dragon City Mobile by Social Point, I'm a bit less fan of this one, but it's really colorful, so I think it helps also to stop to scroll down. And you have one evolution of one character that is evolving. Then you have War Alliance Good Game. So this one is really gameplay oriented, but their strength is really on the voiceover. So they are using a lot of sound effects that are really nice and really make us want to stop to scroll down. Then Empire Four Kingdom again by Good Game Studio. So they have a lot of ads on TikTok lately. And it's basically the evolution of what you build at the beginning. You have nothing, and then it gets bigger, and you get your kingdom. Rise of Kingdom, so another kingdom. Here you have once again another narrative that they are pushing. What you can notice is that the text is in French, and indeed in TikTok, it's really localized. Like the only stories I see, to be honest, are in French. So I think it's something definitely to test, to localize your ads, at least the subtitle. So you see like the subtitle is something that is added, and even here you have a number, so you see those 5% bonus, and it's really something that is used a lot. Then War Alliance, another good game, really good one, and you see really well the character that is looking at you, and you can personalize, and you have a lot of diversity in the kind of character that you want to use. It's really smart because the TikTok audience is really diverse, and I feel like being inclusive is a really a competitive advantage for you, especially on TikTok, where the audience is really, really wide. So well done, Good Game Studio. Then Snake.io apps, they are really smart here. They use the tutorial mechanic. So here you see one find an unsuspected snake, two blah blah, and three blah blah. So you see here it's something that is really organic to TikTok, where influencer or TikToker basically they say, okay, so one you do this, two you do this, three you do this. So using it in ad, it's definitely attention grabbing because people they want to know how to do it, and so they follow the step, they keep being focused on your ad. Miniclip, another really good ad from Miniclip Baseball Clash that gets really high quality creative 3D. I think here you see really well what is happening. You also see the sky that is really beautiful, and it's actually what you see on TikTok, those kind of really beautiful image where you see a lot of travel TikToker and so on. So I feel it's really good. Then you go back on the purpose of the game that is